We start terrorizing our halls here. Here we got a strange looking praying mantis, some kind of praying mantis genus or species. Heck, I don't know. That's for the biology teachers to figure out. What I do know about is vocabulary test 12, and let's talk about that. Here we go, kiddos. It's the most powerful sentence in the English language, the compound complex sentence. Your grammar challenge this week, each of your sentences must use an adverb clause to create a compound complex sentence. You learned about complex sentences last week. You learned about compound sentences 3 weeks ago. Now you're going to put them together to make the most powerful sentence in English language. Each of your sentences must contain one compound element as well as being a compound complex sentence. That would be a compound subject or a compound verb, compound object of a preposition, compound direct object, or subject complements, et al. And here you come. Let's see if I can finish this post. Three sentences must put the adverb clause in front of the of an independent clause. There's two independent clauses in a compound sentence. You can put it in front of the primary or the secondary. We're going to talk about that in a second. And your test must contain the basic five, SV, DO, IO, PO, and PA. The compound complex sentence, here it is. It contains two independent clauses and one dependent clauses. For this test, you will make yours with an adverb clause. That's going to be your dependent clause. The adverb clause functions within the compound sentence the same way it would if it were working with a single independent clause. You want help with adverb clauses? Don't remember what we did in Vocabulary Test 11? Check it out here. Compound complex sentences with one adverb clause. You apply the same rules to the compound complex sentence that you would apply to both compound and complex sentences. So, compound sentences, you use a comma and a coordinating conjunction to join the primary and secondary clause, as we can see here, primary clause in green, secondary in blue. Complex sentences made with adverb clauses, well, you use a comma, but only if the adverb clause precedes the independent clause. In this case, our adverb clause is in red. It precedes the independent clause. The story will come out. That's why you need a comma. If it were the other way around, no comma. This sentence could also be written, without the comma, primary clause first, or independent clause first, dependent adverb clause second, no comma. Compound complex sentences, here we go. Same rules. You use a comma when you're joining the two independent clauses, and you use a coordinating conjunction, and you use a comma only if the adverb clause precedes an independent clause, regardless of whether the independent clause is primary or secondary. So the dependent clause, which is an adverb clause, is in red down here. And the independent clauses are in green and blue. In this case, our independent clause is, this primary clause is green, secondary clause blue. And you can look through these examples. Let's see, what's the big difference here? In this case, we do have the adverb clause in the secondary clause preceding the independent clause, so you have two commas in that sentence. We've touched on this a number of times in class. So this shouldn't be new to you. Diagramming a compound complex sentence. I'm doing a recording, all right? When we diagram a compound complex sentence, when we diagram compound complex sentences, we combine the rules we learned for both compound and complex sentences. Because adverb clauses can precede or proceed any independent clause, it's important to note where the adverb clause is located in the compound sentence. It could be connected to either the primary or secondary clause. Adverb clause in the primary sentence. You can put it in front of the primary clause, then you need the comma. You can put it after the primary clause, and then you don't use a comma. In this case, the only comma we have is the comma that separates our primary clause from our secondary clause. In this case, we have our primary clause here in green, our secondary clause in blue. There's our comma separating them. And because the adverb clause precedes the primary clause, you need a comma there. And here's some examples. Let's roll through these. That's what the whole thing would look like. And because it's diagrammed, because the story is told, the adverb clause is attached to the primary clause, it comes off of the primary clause's verb. You can see here's the primary clause. You can see the adverb clause coming off of its verb. I'm going to do the adverb clause second because it really belongs with the primary clause. And there's our secondary clause. And all together, we can see the three pieces. And as you know, that sentence could be written two different ways. It could be written either somewhere or some other way. Oh, either one of these ways, but it's diagrammed the same way. Let's look at when we have the adverb clause and the secondary clause. So here our primary clause is the same in green, and our secondary clause in this case is in blue. Well, they're both in blue. In this case, we can see the adverb clause precedes the secondary clause, so we have two commas. In this case, we have a three-level tier, our primary clause up on top, then it's our secondary clause, and you can see the adverb clause is joined to the secondary clause because it's in the secondary clause. If we look at that sentence, we're going to go up there to the sentence, which looks like this. Yes, there we go. Our primary clause stands alone. Our secondary clause, in this case, comes right after it, and then the adverb clause proceeds. And in this case, we have the adverb clause preceding the comma. It is that adverb clause belongs to the secondary clause. Your words and flashcards can be found here: essential, expel, exaggerate, falter, fate. And you can get your flashcards here. Again, there's going to be 8 words on the cards, but you're only looking for these words because I'm too lazy to figure out how to split them up. Back out here, there you go. Essential, expel, exaggerate, falter, and fate. These other 3 will begin our vocabulary for vocabulary test 13. But right now, we just care about vocabulary test 12. Hope you had a wonderful time listening to me ramble on about this, and I didn't bore you too much. If you have any questions, leave it in the comment section below. Masalema.